to how it is 85% and 15%. On any given day, a sleeper class ticket, sleeper class because the Shramik Express only has sleeper class tickets, only 1,200 sleeper classes per train were allowed to function. So any sleeper class ticket is 57% subsidized by the Indian Railway any given day, be it a lockdown day or not a lockdown day. And since only 1,200 tickets were functional in a Shramik Express, because instead of six, only two were traveling because of social distancing. The train which reaches the destination comes out empty, returns empty without any passengers in it. Then we have the medical facilities and food, etc. That's the reason as to why during the lockdown phase, the Shramik Express's subsidy from 57% goes up by 28% to become 85%. It's but natural that the rest of the amount is 15%, which the state government should have taken care of, like Madhya Pradesh. Madhya Pradesh
had answered.
Yogendra Yadav, why the Congress, just a minute.
You have been tracking this issue perhaps longer than both the main parties. I know you've been writing about it. There are two arguments. The BJP says it is the state government which should have contributed and therefore the subsidy has been provided through the center. That's what they are claiming. And 85% is being provided through the center. The Congress, on the other hand, says the BJP has woken up to this only after Sonia Gandhi made a statement there today. And there may be some, and that's their argument. Where does the truth lie?
Out, but I'll simply place two simple facts and let's cut through this entire clutter. The two simple questions are, how much is being paid and who pays? I'm very happy that Mr. Sambit Patra has actually admitted the fact. The simple fact is, Rajdeep, just to make matters simple, I've actually brought the same ticket that Mr. Sambit Patra has tweeted today. This is from Vasai to Gorakhpur. How much does it normally cost to travel from Vasai to Gorakhpur in the pre-lockdown days if you travel by a super fast express? I checked with eight trains. There are eight trains whose figures I checked. The fare varies from 660 rupees to 680 rupees in normal times. What is being charged now? If 85% story was true, as was being told through the day, then you would normally imagine that, all right, instead of 680 rupees, now the center would pay about 600 and the poor worker of the state has to pay only 15%, that's about 100 rupees. That is not the case. So in the ticket that Mr. Patra himself has circulated, what are the workers being charged? 740 rupees, not 680. So fact one, the ticket is more than it is normally the case. What has changed is Railway's notional calculation of how much it is subsidizing. Mind you, Railway has been subsidizing for the last 70 years. These are notional calculations. For the worker who was traveling, today it costs more than it
What's your second point?
Ago. Number two, who pays? Who pays? It is absolutely clear in the notification issued by Railways itself that Railway will not issue tickets from the counter. Railway will give the tickets, let's say in this case, to Maharashtra government. Maharashtra government will take 1,000 tickets.
We will try and get back to Yogendra Yadav. Yes, go ahead.
Government to ensure that it collects the fares from them. It says, collect the ticket fare and hand over the total amount to Railways. This is the responsibility of Maharashtra government. So yes, they would pay. The only difference is either the receiving government, in this case, Uttar Pradesh, can say to a Maharashtra government, don't worry, we'll pay you the amount. Otherwise, Maharashtra government can say, we'll pay the amount. In this case, none of the two applied. The workers themselves had to pay. And Mr. Sambit Patra is wrong when he says Bihar government has already done that. No, sir. Bihar government is saying, pay on your own, board the train, come to Bihar, stay quarantined for 21 days. After that, we would reimburse. That is what Bihar government is saying.
Just a minute. And all of this, Yogendra, has come in the last 24 hours, Dr. Patra. All of this has come in the last 24 hours. Remember, it was on Friday night, Saturday morning that that the entire process started of train. In fact, Thursday night, Friday morning of trains suddenly being given permission to take migrants back home. Thiruvananthapuram, Telangana were the states from where Kerala and Telangana were the states from where the trains began movement. My point to you is, it's taken you now 72 hours suddenly for your chief ministers to say, don't worry, we will subsidize the passengers. And that, whether you like it or not, post-dates what Sonia Gandhi did. You got into this only after Sonia Gandhi raised the red flag.
No, I firmly believe that you are very active in the social media. You should have seen as to when Mr. Shivraj Singh Chauhan, the Chief Minister of Madhya Pradesh, announced that. It was 22 hours before even Sonia Gandhi made a statement.
One state, sir.
Just a second. Rajdeep, why do you jump into whenever I speak? You never interject anyone else. Please have some patience. Number one, let me one by one refute the charges. First and foremost, I have been extremely clear right from the very beginning that this government does not want to encourage any kind of mass exodus of the migrant workers also. So there has to be state accountability, and there has to be the state which in fact doles out some amount of money, 15% as it may be, because that will produce a responsible state and we would not see rails almost overflowing with people and spreading disease across the country, number one.
Yes.
Number two. As far as Bihar government statement, what Mr. Yogendra Yadav stated is absolutely right. That they would be reimbursing it on a later date. And that, in fact, would be an incentive for these laborers, for these migrant workers to stay in quarantine. If you complete your quarantine time period alone, then you will get the money. Otherwise, remember, today, in fact, there's a mudsling happening between the Punjab government and the Maharashtra government. Both the chief ministers are fighting because Captain Amarinder Singh says that it is because of the irresponsible attitude of the Maharashtra government that the Nanded infection and 65% of infection has taken place in Punjab. It was on your channel that Mr. Amarinder Singh said that. So these